The question here is at a broader level. Ms. Vaidyanathan, I would like to come back to you. You see, I have read the NCPCR rules. Beyond the point, there is no point criticizing the NCPCR. It's so detailed. It even says that detaining a child in a library or a classroom, sarcasm to a child that lowers the child's dignity, using derogatory remarks, yes, belittling a child, all of these are not acceptable. Problem is, Ms. Vaidyanathan, that all of this is in the hands of a body that can at the most give a report. Now, when the report goes to a police station, the police officer can just pick up the NCPCR report and put it in his cupboard. Nothing's going to come of it. You see, at the most, it can be a point of argument.
So I think it...
Yes.
See, Arnab, I do think that the NCPCR does what it's supposed to do. Be a recommendatory body, research, communicate the findings, and make recommendations. Ultimately, the proof will lie in where the action happens. I think it is the responsibility of all principals. The child is handed over with such great care to them, in trust. And I think we need to take responsibility and make sure that such instances are prevented in schools. I do agree with every point of view that we have just heard, stating that our teachers require continuous training. The teacher training colleges, at the cost of reputation, I must say, must have an effective section on the rules that govern all these things, and also make public to the teachers that if they are in this profession, the most important thing is a caring environment. The trust, the communication that happens between the two and between all factors within the school needs to be respected and looked after with a lot of commitment. And if a teacher defaults, I don't think we should really wait. Of course, the law must take its course, because everyone has a right to appeal, a right to justify, and a right to say what they want. But I think in matters of dealing with children, because they are not adults, any such violation must be dealt with very,
very seriously.
I don't think the teacher needs to get a second
chance. And immediately.
I don't think the teacher is right for this profession.
Yeah, I agree.
Certainly, if anyone who is abusing a child, either through word, thought, or deed, let alone the corporal punishment, I think needs to be dealt with very strictly. There is no excuse for them.
No, but
they don't need to be in this profession.
You know, when I was going through the details, Ms. Ishwaran, yeah, I found that there were many cases I picked up in the last few years. In all of these cases, what happens, an FIR is filed, then nothing happens. And I'm sorry to sound cynical. You know, as long as this story is on the channels, it's in the media, then these people pretend they want to act. The moment the cameras go away, the moment the media pressure goes off, it's back to normal. You see, the only victim at the end of the day, Ms. Ishwaran, remains the child. Most of these cases, this is what has happened.
This is why... But Arnab, this is why I said that, you know, it's important that the schools and the management, just like Lata said just now, have to take responsibility. For example, when I was the principal, or if I'm a principal of a school and this incident occurs, I mean, I would first and foremost suspend, terminate that teacher, and, you know, not wait for an FIR and other things to happen. You know, you don't wait. You give instant punishment. That's the only way that the message also goes home. And as a principal or the management of the school, you need to sensitize your employees that this is unacceptable. And if this action happens, this is going to be what you will be dealt with, that you will be removed from the school. It has to be made very clear. Now, you cannot pussyfoot on issues like this. So even though you are looking at it at a broader sense, it actually has to be executed at the school level. And the head of every school has to be clear in their mind as to what they will not tolerate in their institution. Because if they are clear, then it will not happen in that school.
You know,
and so no principal can escape the responsibility.
You see, Ms. Ishwaran and Lata Vaidyanathan and Mr. Tikku, you know, when I see those pictures, and I want to put those pictures out again, the only thing, you know, your heart goes out for this child. And I just want to say this, you know.
Arnav, one's heart will go out to any child who's even slapped. I mean, having blood and going to the hospital is like horrific. But even slapping a child is heartbreaking, especially when they are 6 and 7 and 8 years old and they are not able to retaliate
it
is heartbreaking.
I want to say this, that, you know, we need to know what happened. This child, you know, what he was... this child was being punished because he was actually preparing for Teacher's Day with a group of other children. And they were playing with some cans, and
it's really sad that
teacher thought he was being too mischievous. This child was actually preparing. This child was preparing to welcome and his teachers and celebrate Teacher's Day, and this is how he has suffered. And if this does not shake the conscience of our nation, if the minister involved, you know, should not have to wait for a Times Now report or a news channel report to react, I really feel quite sad that very often one gets a sense we have to goad our authorities to do something. Coax them, push them, pressurize
and
them
to
do something.
Adnan, the principal, what was the principal of the school doing?
It's a valid question, Mr. That is a valid, valid question.
Yeah, Arnab, I don't think we should wait for Times Now channel to say something about such instances.
I agree with
you. Exactly.
The principal or the head of the institution must dismiss the teacher and wait for any other kind of legal action.
Well,
I don't think she or he deserves any kind of support from anybody in the society.
I agree. And you know,
children who are so vulnerable.
Ms. Ishwaran and Lata Vaidyanathan, you know, you are both very well-known educationists. People like you can take a step and force the government to take action if you act collectively as teachers. And Vinod Kumar Tikku, I don't want to, you know, you're not the villain of the piece here, but NCPCR needs to be given some teeth, some real teeth to act, because your intentions are right, but you don't have your powers.
I also would like to interrupt here. Arnab,
yes.
I would like to interrupt here. There are the certain amount of teeth is available, but not the full teeth. But in case when I was telling you that the mindset needs to be changed, I'll just tell you an example of when we had regional consultation in Calcutta. I had spoken to few of the elite class parents who really still believe that some kind of discipline. You know, the word discipline itself connotes the negative feeling.
Discipline is not physical. Discipline
that is
in the
why
mind.
We have removed the word discipline from the corporal
this
punishment guidelines.
That beating, corporal punishment is a perverse definition of discipline. It is a sign of weakness.
Yes.
And it's a worst example of teaching.
Absolutely.
Well, I have to wrap up, but I think we have come to some conclusion on this. We put the pressure, and I promise we'll follow the story with the authorities. For your time tonight, ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much. Tell us what you think of the stories we brought to you tonight. We have big political exclusives coming up tomorrow. And as I said, one expose on Colgate every night, another one coming up tomorrow. I'll see you tomorrow evening with the big news, the relevant debate. Good night and goodbye. We'll be right back.